fine Sunday. Good morning to everyone. We're back here in Bern with semifinal action of the International Berner Damen Cup, featuring this game, Russia's Moiseeva against Switzerland's Pätz, the European champion, against the 2015 world champion. And the lineup, Julia Gotseva, Galina Arsenkina, Uliana Vasileva, Victoria Moiseeva at skip, Julia Fortunova at alternate. And for the Swiss team, locals Nicole Schrackley, Marissa Winkelhauser, Nadine Lehmann, and Alina Pätz at skip. Miriam Ott, coach. My name is Armin Harder. And with me today, once again, is Al Moore, coach of the Swiss national women's teams.
Good morning.
Hello, Al. This is Curling Champions Tour in cooperation coverage, World Curling TV production here from Bern. Wonderful eight-sheet facility. The ice conditions have been great all weekend. Organization has been super. Really put on a great event. And of course, we got some really good teams playing in this. Al, what's your prognosis? You've been watching these two teams. You, of course, you know them quite well, especially Team Pätz.
Moiseeva is on a real roll this year. She was originally ranked at 124th in the world and won her way into the European Championships with a victory over countryman Anna Sidorova. Proved it was no fluke by going on to win the European Championships. Been on quite of a roll, too, I believe. They've been rolling through here. They just came through a quarterfinal match over Sigfridsson from Sweden, which they won quite easily. So they're really rolling. Pätz came through the A side of this Bonspiel. They've had maybe a disappointing year from their standpoint, but they're ready to turn on now. They recently, a couple of weeks ago, were in the semifinals of the U.S. Open tournament.
And they've had a little bit of rest since they came through here undefeated.
Yeah, both
is that going to play a factor?
Well, both these teams played this morning. They've been off the ice only for about 45 minutes or so. So just a chance to catch their breath, get some fuel, and talk to their coaches a little bit about their game plan. Okay. By virtue of qualifying through the A event, Alina Pätz has last stone in the first end. And I think they'll be looking to try and jump to an early lead. Moiseeva is not going to let them off the hook, though. They're not throwing their first stone in the house. They threw a guard. They want to get this game underway, and they're ready to rock and roll right from the first end.
Moiseeva with a 6-1 record and, in this tournament, and Alina Pätz with a 5-0 record. So Moiseeva's had two games more.
I believe Moiseeva did come through the B road.
That's correct, and both these teams have faced each other certainly at tour level this year. They've already faced each other in this tournament in the early rounds.
In fact,
Pätz was the only defeat that Moiseeva had. It was a 7-5 victory for Pätz, and they faced each other last year, actually in 2015 at the Women's Masters in Basel, and Pätz won that game also. So only two times on the tour that they've faced each other.
We do have four games going on the ice. Two of the games are consolation events, and the other semifinal is Switzerland's Silvana Turnzoni against former world champion Binyu Wang of China.
Yeah, that should be a pretty good matchup, too, I would think. So some real good experience. Two world champions in the semifinals, or former world champions. Tirinsoni, like third on the world team ranking, the order of merit. And Moiseeva, European champion, and certainly on an upswing. pretty important for a team like that who's been sitting in the shadows of Sidorova to finally break out and get some experience and some accolations at the higher level.
Yeah, and I think they want to show the coaches and the powers back home that they deserve everything that they're now getting, and that it isn't a fluke that they won the Russian championship, and it isn't a fluke that they won the Europeans, and they can compete at the highest level. And they're proving it.
Talking about maximizing your opportunities, I would think.
Yeah, absolutely. So fairly straightforward first end, one guard in play. It's long enough that, and there's enough curl in this ice, there's a lot of finish late in the ice. Great accolades to the ice makers for providing such a fabulous surface. These stones this year are brand new, so there shouldn't be any issues with any of the equipment that's out there.
They've been working quite well, but you do need to put a rotation on those rocks to make sure that they do run consistently.
Yeah, they are a bit sharper than perhaps some of the other stones around the world. But both these teams are experienced enough that they're aware of that, and I don't suspect any issues with rotation from these players.
Hammer efficiency throughout the event. I'll let you talk about what this means. But throughout the event, Moiseeva's had a 57, almost 60% hammer efficiency. Pätz, a little less at 43%.
Yeah, anything over 40 is actually very good, so 57 is pretty incredible, and that just means that when they do have last stone, that they're able to generate two or more points. So if you can generate two or more points over 40% of the time, and of course competing against the world's top teams, that's that puts your team in a great position.
And Moiseeva, explain quickly what the hammer is
last stone in the first end, or last stone in any end is the team that has the hammer. Hammer is a slang word for last stone in the first end, in any end, sorry. And the efficiency is that you score 2 points with it. So if you score 2 points, if you have a last stone advantage 4 times during a game and you score 2 points 3 times, that would be an efficiency of about 75%. And as I say, top teams in the world, 40% is a very good number.
The force efficiency statistics, and I'll get you to explain that, those numbers I find even more astounding.
Okay, force is when the other team has last stone and you're forcing them to 1 point. You'd like to always force the opponent to have 1 point when they have last stone, and of course you'd like to score 2 when you have last stone. So the force efficiency is the ability to hold the opposition to 1 point when they have last stone.
So Moiseeva has been at 64% and Pätz has a 70% force efficiency. So compared with their hammer efficiency and their force efficiency, this should be quite interesting.
It tells you why they're both here in the semifinals.
That means you're playing the scoreboard. You're doing a good job with it, eh?
You are. That means probably in an 8-end game, your opponent has last stone 4 times, and 3 of those 4 times you held them to 1 point.
So this has been a defensive start here in the first end.
Yeah, there was one guard, but we had one roll out, and the guard quickly disappeared. A lot of teams now with last stone in the first end would like to blank the first end and nobody scores and take their last rock advantage to the second end, the even end, and try and get their two in the second end. Teams like to score in even ends.
Just, I don't know if that's biting, just barely biting on the outside. Pätz has the hammer. It's hard to see from this angle if that rock's biting, because there is a curvature to that rock. If you stand directly over top of it.
And the camera is positioned right over top of the center hole in the ice, so it's looking at a bit of an angle toward that stone. The players obviously feel it's in the ring, so they're going to make a play on it.
Tilangi!
pretty well just trade rocks. Now that may not be biting it. I'm gonna take a look at it. Must just be close though.
Yeah. I think they think it's out. They're just gonna draw into the house.
How about an angle freeze to that?
Tough shot. You're trying going around the edge of it. Dangerous if you're not really sure of the ice, you might just actually push it in the rings and give your opponent a chance for
That's
2 points.
Freeze to the front. Give Alina a tough one in the first end.
They're playing on ice three here.
It's the first time we've seen the sheet. We've been covering sheet eight all weekend. The camera's over to the
yeah, we had to
sheets.
had to get a crew of about 100 people to move all the equipment over five sheets.
And Al never exaggerates.
I'm sure there's 100 people in that room.
Would you believe one angry Boy Scout with a bug in it? Who was that?
And that sounds like Maxwell Smart.
Maxwell Smart.
Played by Don Adams. Or Steve Carroll in the movie. Don't try and trick me on trivia stuff.
Al's been around 100 years. He's seen it all.
And remember most of it. So this is important that they determine whether this is in or out. They're either going to try and hit and stick for two, and they're just confirming that they all believe it's out. Or hit and roll out. Now, if I was Moiseeva and Alina rolls out, I'd actually put a stick on that. And if it happened to be in, then it would be a force. And if, on the other hand, if I'm Alina and I stick, she's trying to roll out, but if I stick and hit this one on the nose, I'll put a measuring stick on that one to see whether I scored two. Mm-hmm. So either way, there'll probably be a measuring stick thrown on that zone.
I would think with Stefan Rutley's bag of hairs, head ice maker, those rings are probably pretty exact, but...
Yeah, they're down to the nearest angstrom, I think.
You never know if he had a case of beer before he did the ice that night, or... I don't think we're going to see a measure, are we?
No, they've agreed it's out. It's a blank end.
So, after first end of play here at the International Berner Damen Cup, or Ladies Cup, we have a score of 0-0, and Pätz maintains the hammer going into the next end. So second in action continues here with Curling Champions Tour coverage in conjunction and in cooperation with World Curling Federation and World Curling Television. We're covering this on YouTube channel, Champions Tour YouTube channel, the World Curling TV YouTube channel. It's also going to go on a number of television stations throughout Europe.
So, Moiseeva trying to put a guard in play and force the issue a little bit more. Team Pätz trying to play a soft peel, move that stone off the center line and perhaps roll their shooter into the rings as well. Perfectly done. If Moiseeva had been able to sweep that stone of her own over to the line, everything would have gone back because you're not allowed to remove the opponent's stone from the free guard zone until four stones have been played. free guard zone being the area in front of the house to the tee line, but not touching the house. So now that we've got the center opened, Team Pätz will be playing a guard to the side, a corner guard. And we'll know right away whether Moiseeva is going to take an aggressive form or a defensive form. If she goes around that corner guard or throws a guard herself, she's going to try and force the issue against Pätz. However, if she just peels the guard off, then she's going to be quite content to let Pätz blank another end. This one's come a little deep though, so obviously there's no question that Moiseeva is going to play a takeout on it. They wanted that stone to stop in front of the house and hope that they could get something in behind it later on. So it was a little bit of a mistake by Nicole Schwegli of Team Pätz. Alina's going to ignore that stone in the house and play a little more aggressive. She's going to throw corner guard to the side on the opposite side. She really wants to try and generate her 2 points this end, and hitting that one with the skill of these players, you're rarely going to see an open miss on a takeout.
You mentioned that Alina has not had in her best season. She was well established in the top 10 in the last 2 years. She's now slid down to 20 from the world team ranking order of merit. Certainly this would be the time to turn it around.
Yeah, they'll have their Swiss championships coming up in the next 3 weeks, and they certainly want to get on a roll now. They've been working very hard, working with mental trainers, and I know I've done a few sessions with them. They came to Vancouver and we spent 3 days on the ice there, and they're hoping to turn things around. And I said recently, 2 weeks ago, they had some success at the US Open, finishing in the semifinals.
So nobody risking anything here so far.
Well, Pätz is trying to get something going, but Moiseeva not having anything to do with that. She's going to just keep it clean. She may at some point decide to draw and sit two to force Pätz to one and not allow Pätz to blank. Pätz could use that stone that's in the house and try and go behind it, use it as a guard and try and go behind it to the back of the 8 foot. And you may see her do that if this stone is peeled off. You may see her do that with the next stone.
We see our ice maker, Stefan Rutlisberger. A lot of international experience.
Yeah, he works hard to give these players a great surface. It was a pretty heavy draw. As I said, at one point, Moiseeva may try to sit two to force Pätz into her single. And that was the attempt right there, but that draw sailed through the house. So now Pätz will use that corner guard and endeavor to get one in behind it herself. She can get shot stone and fully in the 8 foot behind the stone. She's giving about 2 meters, a little 1.5 meters of ice. That's how much curl she believes that the stone will have.
Madeline Lehmann. This team came together 2 years ago, 3 years ago. Two players used to play with Yaki.
Okay.
So they've had a pretty quick rise to the top, I would say.
Yeah, they gelled fairly quickly. Now, they didn't get shot on that stone, but it is pretty well undercover, maybe a third of it showing. So, Moiseeva outlining her options there, so we can play the run back or just draw to sit second shot. They've elected to draw. This is the same shot that they just played. Uliana just played and she was heavy, so hopefully she'll have a better feel for this spot. It's exactly the same path down the ice. It was probably a determining factor in making the call.
This looks like it needs to slow down quite a bit. Needs to come to a stop, a second shot.
And it's heavy once again. It's sitting his third shot, so the yellow is definitely two. Well, Pätz has two options here. She's going to have to roll in a bit to, I think, to get shot. She can also try and roll long behind the yellow stone that's already there and sit two undercover. I think that's what her call indicated. So Nadine Lehmann, the only left-hander on the ice.
On the sheet.
This sheet of ice. And that's
nice
really
roll.
Well done.
Yeah, very good. Rolled maybe a little too far.
Yeah, I think.
Exposed on the other side. Yeah, just.
Half a stone on the other side.
So a big opportunity here for Moiseeva. Is she getting on the inside of that?
Yeah, she'd have to, I think, be pretty close to the guard. The danger is getting that close to guard. You might actually chip that guard into the house and leave Pätz a draw for four. Because I presume she's only playing hack weight here.
That's a negative way of looking at it, Al.
That's positive here in the Pätz team.
Okay. I understand.
So it looks like she's playing hack weight. She, like I said, if she ticks that top yellow stone, she actually pushes it into the house. With hack weight, probably wouldn't be enough weight to take it out.
She needs to get it to the inside of this, otherwise she's jamming it on the back, too.
Yep. And this is probably the first time they've been out this far, so a little bit of a guess on how much this is going to curl.
Wouldn't throw much more than hack, I would think.
Taking a little less ice.
Still guessing, though, I bet. Victoria Moiseeva.
Waiting for some curl.
That needs to curl a bit more. Just gets the angle wrong. And
that's exactly what they didn't want to do. Pätz can make a play on that stone, and she'll be looking to roll inside, and they were looking really closely at how much that stone curled themselves so that they could have a good idea of the speed to throw.
Well, this shot here certainly is much easier, and she gets a perfect roll.
If she can roll in behind these two, if she can roll in behind these two yellow stones, this is all set up by Uliana coming too deep with both of her draws. What seemed like a harmless situation could potentially turn into a big score by Team Pätz here.
And this is staying wide too, I think. I should just let Moiseeva off the hook a little bit.
So she's left the hit and roll back to Moiseeva, who really must make this.
Yes.
hit on the nose here. We'll just give Pätz
a straight draw
for three or an open hit for three. So she really, really needs to make this roll. Option, of course, she could play a freeze down to the back one, be shot by freezing on the back stone. Which is probably actually, in my opinion, a little easier shot, a little more room for error. Looks about the same amount of ice as Pätz just took, and Pätz hit it in the nose, so.
It's just the weight.
It all depends on the weight and the release and how your stone reacts compared to your opponent. Sounds like this is outside a little bit.
If it won't be outside, then that would be disastrous. Let's go for the double. Yeah. Ooh. Well, there we have it. Free draw for three here in the second.
Yeah, I don't know. I think in that situation,
tighten it up, throw it hard.
Throw a little harder, but freeze to that back one might have been a better call. They'd seen that path a few times.
Mm-hmm. You don't make that, you're giving up four.
Three or four, it's not a big difference.
Oh, okay. So a fairly simple, straightforward draw here for Alina Pätz in the second end to take a fairly commanding start to this game. Still, you got to make this.
Pressures like it.
Now, with his proficient Swiss, understands everything.
More than I let on.
There we go. Big three here in the second end of the semifinal. And that Pätz goes up 3-0 after two ends of play. Beginning of the third end here at the International Burner Cup. We're here from the Almend, the Expo area region of Bern.
Yeah, I'm surprised you're here. I thought you were going to be at the Vacation Expo that's right next door.
I was thinking about it, but why tease myself something that I...
The National Equestrian Center is right across the street. The home arena of the Bern Bears hockey team is a few meters away, so it's a real center.
The football stadium is right across the street, too, from the Bern Young Boys.
Stadium de Suisse.
Stade de Suisse, yeah.
Bern Young Boys play there in the premier football division in Switzerland. So this is a hub of sporting activity in this area.
And home to the Curling Champions Tour. International Bern Damen Cup, which is in its 49th edition. Well,
wow, that's pretty impressive.
Very impressive, yep. And it's always been a premier event and well organized. Anita Yaki, president of that organization, doing a great job this weekend with her entire team and staff.
Yeah, and I believe the international part of this tournament really stands out. I think we have 11 countries represented here this week.
China, Japan, Canada, USA. Top European teams. In the other semifinal, Tiransoni opened with a deuce in the first end. Wang came back with one, and they're now in the third end. Tiransoni up 2-1 with the hammer.
So Team Pätz draw a little bit behind the tee line, didn't really want it there. That's something that Moiseeva can use later. However, right now she'd like to get a stone in behind the corner guard. You'll see Team Pätz go on the defense and start peeling and making takeouts as many stones as they can, probably for the remainder of this end. I'd really like to hold Moiseeva to a single point this end. Worst case scenario, if they make all perfect shots, they conceded two, but struggling a little bit with the speed of the ice. That one's come up short. So Team Pätz is going to use up weight to try and double off of both of those stones and roll the shooter out of play. They want to hit the stone a little bit on the outside, across the top of the red guard right by Alina Pätz's feet. Shooter, of course, out of play. Just missing it. And just missing their own in the house as well. So the corner guard's still there. It's the second corner guard, the attempted draw, so a little tougher to get behind because it's close to the house. But
well, key here is that Moiseeva's team gets their draw weight now and starts putting rocks into better position.
Yeah, they've been heavy on the first end, a little light this end. Galina Arsenkina throwing now. Great mechanics. If you want to copy somebody's delivery, she'd be a good one to copy.
This looks a little bit better.
Yeah, tightly by the guard.
There's a nice shot.
Didn't really finish as much as I thought it would.
It slid a lot further than it looked like it was going to.
Yeah, it is not shot stone, but I think it's probably three quarters covered. Alina's going to ignore that for the time being and just peel the corner guard out of the way. She knows that Moiseeva has to make a play on her stone back there, and it might potentially set up a double later on.
Good shot there from Marisa, getting rid of that guard.
So it's pretty clean in front of the house now. We just have the two stones in the back behind the tee line. Moiseeva has two shots she could play. She's elected. She's going to guard her own stone, even though it's not shot. Or she could try a freeze or a slight tap back on the Pätz stone at the back of the 8 foot. Pressure's just keeping it clean. Speed's good.
Putting guards on with this much curl is a bit tricky, isn't it?
It's a little tricky, yeah, because there's so much finish in the last couple of meters of the stone. As you see, that one over-curled a little bit, so Pätz can see maybe half of the stone in the back of the house, and they're going to make a play on it. Probably with something a little bit less than their normal takeout weight, they want to try and save the shooter. I'm not sure that's really a wise idea, because it's going to roll over beside the other yellow stone and maybe create a pocket. So a rollout would be equally good, I think.
Nadine Lehmann.
Yeah, they didn't really want to stay down beside their other stone. But the corner guard's still there, and I don't know if she can get shot behind it. I don't think so. She'd get totally buried, but they can certainly get one undercover. Juliana struggled with her speed in the last stand, so she's hoping to find it here.
It's not long. Three sweepers out there.
All three of them.
Too often anymore.
Good brushing, though.
Good brushing, yep.
Nice shot. That's about as good as they can do.
Happy with that.
I don't know if Pätz is trying to run back or just a straight peel. looks like just a straight peel, that much ice. Of course, the faster you do throw a curling stone, the straighter it goes.
Nadine, I believe, a police officer on the train system here for SBB train system. And they get both of them.
That wasn't what they actually played. They were playing the peel on the front one. She went by it by a hair and picked the one in the house out. And moved her own over. Might even made that one a little closer by hitting it straight sideways.
Exactly the same thing she just threw, so.
Nice shot.
Well, she's got to be pleased probably with the, she knows her rocks are identical also.
Yeah, she's finally got her draw weight back. So Alina could just draw in to the, past that stone in the house and sit two. However, she probably has a memory of that's exactly what Moiseeva tried last end and ended up giving up a three. Ender, so she's not going to get fooled into that play. She's going to just play the straight. I think she's, with this one, with the thin amount of ice, I believe she is playing the run back.
And they're pretty close together. There's not a lot of separation between the guard and the second shot the Russians have there. She gets one.
And the shooter rolls out of play.
Now an opportunity for Moiseeva to sit with two.
You know, I think maybe last end, Moiseeva tried to split the house with her thirds first, which was maybe a little early. This being Skip's first stone on this end, I think if I'd been Alina Pätz, I might have played the draw there.
Yeah, I agree. But it would have been difficult to place it without setting up some sort of double with the way those rocks are spread out.
Perhaps a double. He could have tried to go back 8 foot.
Back 8 foot on the right-hand side.
On the right-hand side,
that.
Just so they're even, leaving no double.
You don't have a lot of room to draw to, though.
No, it's a pretty small spot to be perfect.
Oh, Moiseeva hoping to hit here on the nose. Leaving a difficult double angle.
They're working it hard.
That kind of makes it, puts it closer to the red one. And Alina does have a chance here to maybe double them out.
Yeah, I think they might take a run at it. They're not too concerned about saving the shooter. They're just more concerned with eliminating the two red stones. So she'd be quite content if she was to make this double and let Moiseeva blank. So it looks like she has to hit about three quarters of that top red stone on the outward side. Probably throwing it clearing speed, which is their fastest speed they throw. Takes probably about 7.5 seconds to get between the hog lines.
Can you throw that fast, huh?
I used to be able to when I was young. That was like 80 years ago.
Was that before the last war?
Yeah. I think my peel weight now is more like 10 seconds.
Just misses it.
Just misses it. It'll be an open house for Moiseeva to score 2 points.
Good attempt there by Alina Pätz. Needs to curl just a hair more.
Another half a centimeter probably would have got that back stone out.
Didn't miss by much. Open house draw. That'll put Moiseeva back within reach again.
Still have to focus and make it.
So both teams, well, we'll see here. both teams could be standing true to their fairly high hammer
efficiency.
Force efficiency not quite working out for either one, though. And that's looking pretty good.
Just discording it down, the weight's perfect.
Just put it right on the button. Oh, so
it's
nice give a satisfaction to the skip to see that on the button.
It's nice to let the skip see one go on the button. You never know when you might need that, and it's always for me, even though the draw only had to be in the house.
So with that deuce in the third end, Moiseeva closing up on Pätz. Pätz still leads 3-2 and has the hammer in the next end. And we're back with the fourth end. So is any trends coming out of this that you've noticed, Al?
Well, I think Moiseeva is probably a little disappointed. The whole team probably disappointed with their performance in the second end when they gift-wrapped a three-ender to Team Pätz. But, you know, good on them for not letting it worry them. Patient in that last end. I think Alina could have thrown the draw in her first one and forced Moiseeva, but it's a new game now.
And we've got a long guard up front now from the Russians.
Team Pätz like to play soft peeling a lot. They use this a lot. A lot of teams don't even try it. They'll just go around guards.
Even in middle early ends. What you end up with is,
They were a little heavy on that one, so because they've taken that stone out of the free guard zone, it gets replaced and the shooter comes off.
A little less, it could have been two corner guards.
Yep, that's what they're looking for. In a perfect world, they wanted to just move them both over so they're covering the 8 foot and they have two corner guards, which is a great offensive situation.
Wang blanked in the third end. Tirinsoni blanked in the third end. So Tirinsoni still 2-1 over Wang after three ends of play and has the hammer. In the other semifinal, 32 teams, triple knockout. Started Thursday evening. And we're down to the last four.
Well, that one didn't get under cover like they were hoping. They're either hoping for it short. They seem to be brushing for it like they want it to stop just short and put another guard up, but it came a little deep. So now Pätz can hit this. And she's indicated she wants to roll open at this point. I don't think she wants to clutter up the center. So she's willing to roll open, exchange maybe a couple of hits, and then get later on in the end, try and get in behind the long guard, score 2 points. Okay, nose hit. Moiseeva would like to hit this one back, perhaps roll a little bit to the center.
Nose hit this.
That's for sure. I got that line path figured out. So Pätz will be looking to roll slightly to one side or the other to set up a corner guard. She could try and roll under, but that might leave a good situation for Moiseeva to draw around it to the button. So I think she's going to try and roll to the open side here.
Yeah.
Okay. She's rolled open on the one side. I really don't want to stay in the center area. Moiseeva, on the other hand, would like to roll back to the center here so that Pätz can't take it out, rolling behind the guard that's there, and then get behind that one later.
Davai. Let's continue. Onwards.
So,
piece of it.
Alina's playing a little defensive here. That's a long guard. It's not on the center line. And certainly she could take this opportunity to go behind it to the top 8 foot, try and score 2 points. But she's going to move it off center line. I think she's going to try and save the shooter over as a corner guard. No, maybe not. Looks like Peel weight. They were trying to save it. They would throw in a quieter speed to try and save it over as a corner guard.
So nothing in play here. No rocks in play anywhere. They're all back in the rock boxes. And I would think that, was that a call into the house here? No?
Well, I think it's a tight guard. They'd like to have a tight guard. So they want this guarded as close to the house as possible. Hope for a little mistake. They are brushing it to the house, though.
No, I thought she was tapping into the house. So. Well, Pätz will probably remove this, I would think.
So I think both teams now have kind of resigned themselves that this is probably going to be a blank end.
Certainly looking that way.
You know, if I'm Team Moiseeva, being down 3-2, I think I might take a little more opportunity to try and throw a tight guard, hope for a little mistake and get behind it, and at least force Pätz to one so I can get hammer back.
Curled a bit.
Now, Pätz could have left that stone just outside the rings, not swept it, and then try to freeze on it. But they're just taking everything out.
When you decide to do something, you carry through with it. You change your mind every 5 minutes?
I'm always looking for an opportunity to score two, you know me. I don't give any opportunities away. I try and use every stone, try and use my opportunity. I feel a blank.
Well, you may not get another opportunity. So
you never know.
You use the one you get.
Right? You never know. I feel a blank is a failure of my skipping abilities to create an opportunity for two.
Well, that's not a very good shot either.
Yeah, maybe focus is not quite there. They kind of looking forward and seeing that this is going to be a blank, let's move forward. But it's close enough to the house that Moiseeva perhaps could freeze it. She's not going to, though. She's going to just draw to the middle. Opportunity for Moiseeva. She knows that Pätz is going to take this stone out, but it's an opportunity to get a good feel for a draw weight. Also for the sweepers to see it. You never know, this might be the final shot of the eighth end. She might just need to throw this exact same shot in the last stone of the eighth end. So she'd kind of like to see what it feels like.
Again, the sweeper's not sweeping that rock to the button. They could have done that.
Yeah, you want to, you know, as a team with that's up and coming, you want to give your skip a view of that stone going, landing on the button. As I said, that might be the shot they need to win the game in the eighth end. So why not practice it right now? Sweep it right to the pinhole. It's the little things. You don't really want to practice brushing a stone to nowhere, no specific spot. You really want to practice brushing a stone to a specific spot.
So now we're hit and stay from Moiseeva. She want to maybe roll, change position on this?
Yeah, change it a bit. Roll over to a corner. Force Pätz to make the shot, but roll it somewhere different.
We've seen a lot of rocks down this line.
Maybe roll it over in front of that other yellow stone. Off chance that Pätz could jam it.
Sweeping for the roll.
So Pätz will be throwing her clearing speed, trying to hit the stone early on the brush side and roll out of the rings to blank the end and move forward to the next end, maintaining her last stone advantage. Well done. Another blank end on the board.
And so with that blank, we are at the halfway point of this game. Pätz continuing to be in control with a 3-2 lead and the hammer going into the second half. Ninth edition of the International Bern Damen Cup, or Ladies Cup. We're here in the capital city of Switzerland, Bern. A little snowy capital last couple of days.
Yeah, the walk back to my apartment has been full hood.
Looks pretty though.
To some.
Yeah. Tourists love it. It is definitely a pretty city.
Yeah, the River Otter winds its way, meanders, I guess, its way through the town.
And this weekend, it's the curling capital of Europe.
Yes, it is. So interesting. Tactics here in the even ends. Pätz tried the split the guard off, and in the odd ends, she's going around that guard. Not that it matters when you get your 2 points. Any end, even or odd, is a good time to score a two.
Yeah,
ближче.
Пока что гард.
Гард 26. Окей, пока очень широко.
So I don't think Moiseeva wants Pätz to blank any more ends, especially the odd ends. She'd like Pätz to take a point in the odd end, and she'd have last stone in the even ends. So she's going to play some draws down here. Didn't curl quite as much as they were hoping.
But we've got three rocks in play.
Yeah, something to watch at. Pätz will be playing quiet weight, hack, board, trying to get to the inside of this red stone and roll in behind the guard in front. It's at 2 points.
Just as a reminder, we will be showing the final Bernese International Diamond Cup. And that final will take place at approximately 14:30, 2:30 Central European time. And we'll be covering that here on Curling Champions Tour YouTube channel or World Curling Tour TV YouTube channel.
It was a little bit of plan B on that last shot. They didn't mind moving that center guard out of the way. Don't want to move it quite so far. It's still a corner guard, still can be used later on. Now Moiseeva has an option here of playing a takeout on her own with quiet weight and sitting two, or hitting the Yellowstone directly and sitting two. But I think she's going to force the issue a little bit and throw a guard on these, even though she's not shot.
Going to Argentina. Wang steals one in the fourth. So that game's all tied up after four ends of play. Two each versus Tirasoni in the other semifinal.
That guard didn't come quite as far as they wanted, maybe a little light. So Team Pätz can see half of this red stone and they'd like to hit it and roll the shooter way over behind the other red corner guard. Probably with board weight. Something less than their normal takeout weight.
Teresa Winkelhausen. Three of these girls from the Bern region. The only foreigner in the team is Alina Pätz. She's from the Zurich area.
I believe not living there now, but she's from there.
She's now living in migrated to the Bern
Interlaken.
Region.
Yeah, she's in the Bern region now.
Passport control to do that.
Yeah. That was not a plan B. They didn't really want to move that guard. They'll take it, but they really wanted to make a play on the one in the house. So once again, looking for a guard. This is an odd tactic when you're guarding the opponent's stone.
Good guard.
And that one's overcurled.
Yeah, just a bit.
Now, Alina already sitting one, could ignore all that stuff there and draw another one around and sit two.
But she but has I think to worry about that center guard.
She has
it's
to worry about that. It's a dangerous stone. So she's recognized it's a dangerous stone. She's going to try and double out the two red stones in the middle. And she does have two corner guards, so even if Moiseeva then hits the yellow one in the center, Lena will have two corner guards to use. Got to be careful not to hit it back onto her own here. Or straight onto the red one and leave it sitting right in front of her shot stone. This is quite a precise shot.
And it's precisely executed.
Perfectly done. And left her own shooter there as a corner guard now. I think you'll see Moiseeva now make the play to try and hit and roll behind one of these corner guards and
go for the force.
Go for the force.
The force being, of course, trying to get the opponent to score one.
Yeah, forcing your opponent to score one. And the way you can force your opponent to score one is either by sitting two in the house that are not in a double situation, or having one of your own behind your own guard, or behind any guard.
Forcing the opponent to draw.
Forcing the opponent to draw for one.
And she gets a bit of a roll, but not quite enough.
She got halfway there, and Alina would like to now get the other half. Roll it right in behind the guard.
That would be rude.
If she can get right behind the yellow one, it might be hard to make the run back, because she may not be able to quite hit the yellow one on the nose with that other red guard guarding the edge of it. They're playing a little quieter, slower speed here. They can control a little more with the brushes.
Go, 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 go!
Trying to hold it straight.
Half of the half.
Rolled it a little bit, but not exactly what they're looking for.
Still room to roll there.
Not sure which way Moiseeva is trying to roll this way, but he's trying to hit it early and roll across the house behind the corner guard on the other side, or cross over.
This looks like a nose hit. Ooh, gets another little bit.
They're getting closer and closer. Over there. So Adelina does have to be pretty close to that guard to get in behind the two on the left.
Don't know there's if you're in the house if you roll over from there.
Yeah, there's no space, I don't think, anyway. So she's going to try and hit about a half a stone and roll all the way over behind the other red corner guard.
Of course, with every hit, that rock has crept further and further forward. Now that roll would not do much for you, because you're not in the rings.
It's close. A little too thin.
Needed to curl a bit more.
I thought they were yelling yes and no, and usually when you hear yes and no, the line is pretty close. But that had to curl another centimeter or so anyway. There's now an opportunity for Moiseeva to get behind one of these guards and force Pätz team to a single point. When you're choosing which one to go behind, you want to go behind the one that's going to get you closer to the center, because if you go behind one and the other team ignores it and goes behind the other one for shot, then your come around was useless. So if Moiseeva goes around the Yellowstone, as you say, she'd be probably half in the 8 foot, half in the 12 foot. And Alina could go around the other red stone and be almost full 8 foot. So Moiseeva should really go around the red stone on the right, so that if Alina did go around the yellow one, Moiseeva would still be shot. Let's get the brush right between them. I believe she is going around the red stone on the right. If she can get it just in front of the tee line, she can be just about full 8 foot. Real good.
Quite a bit of room by that guard. Now it needs to finish.
Maybe just overswept a little bit.
Yeah, I think so too.
You want to really keep that in front of the tee line, because now it's in a position where Pätz can come down and freeze to it and be shot stone.
Did get behind cover.
Four.
Yeah, maybe swept that stone, maybe a stone width too far.
This is, seems to be a trend, or certainly in this game with the sweeping, not as precise as you might like it.
Yep, every shot, there's a perfect spot for every shot to stop, and the brushers really need to be aware of where that spot is and do their best to get it to that spot.
This needs to curl quite a bit too, I think. No bounce.
Just overswept, maybe a little bit, or maybe a little heavy combination. A little too much weight and a little too much brushing. So it bounced off that shot, so that means that Moiseeva, with a nice quiet takeout, can remove it from play and sit two, forcing Pätz into a single point.
She'd kind of like to roll in front of her own there a bit.
Maybe, or even to the back of the forefoot. I don't think she minds giving Pätz an open shot for one. She's not really looking to steal here, really looking to force Pätz to one.
I think with a nose hit, she's got a double blank opportunity.
Perhaps. That's why I say rolling.
Want to roll one way or the other then.
Rolling over to the back of the forefoot would force Pätz to a single point attempt.
Doesn't need to sweep as hard. Gosh, all over the guard. Bad mistake.
Might have got that going a bit in her hand. Just turning it slightly toward the target. And of course, when you do that, it starts curling so quickly.
She lets.
And it gets offline.
Pats right off the hook here and gives her a pretty easy draw to the needs full 8 foot score. 2 points. It's well set up for Moiseeva. Just didn't execute with her last rock.
Yeah, that seemed to start curling early, so I suspect that there's a little bit of help with the release.
Of course, rocks like this, being as aggressive they are, anything, any motion you get doing that, it's gonna get an extreme amount of curl out of it. Alina Pätz, last rock here in the fifth end, looking for 2 points.
Pressure's not even cleaning it right now.
Calling back eight right now. Okay, now it's coming down.
Yeah, they didn't brush it, they let it grab a bit and.
Good enough for two, and that will replace that 3 point advantage that Alina Pätz and her foursome have here in this game. They'll score 5-2 after 5 ends of play. Back into the sixth end here in this semifinal between Switzerland's Alina Pätz, 2015 world champion, which was in Sapporo. We both have very good memories of that week, El.
And I've never had that much sushi before.
We certainly ate a lot of sushi. I think that should be incorporated into all our trips now. Playing against Moiseeva from Russia, the current European champion, and with that error in the last end, she's now got a bit of a work cut out for her to get back in this game. Al, what's the game plan? You're down three, you got 3 ends to go.
Yep, and game plan's clear for Moiseeva. She has to score two, hold Pätz to one and score two and steal the extra end.
Oh, that's easy, okay.
So And Pätz's game plan is don't let that happen.
Now I know why you're a national coach.
So this is where you really want your force efficiency. If you're team Pätz, you want your force efficiency to come to the fore and not let this team get a two. Pätz would be happy just to exchange single points for the next three ends.
Well, speaking of force efficiency, see if we can find that.
Pätz will be playing this second shot, I believe, into the house. They don't really want to put guards in play. More stones that they can put in play, then more chance for Moiseeva. They want to encourage Moiseeva to play a takeout. So if they can play into the house, maybe tap this one that's already there to the forefoot, that would encourage Moiseeva to play a takeout.
As we stated early in the game, both teams with a very high force efficiency.
Hasn't been shown in this game, though.
No, well. Kind of neutralize the hammer efficiency and the force efficiency have kind of neutralized themselves.
Yeah.
The steel efficiency for Moiseeva is at 44%.
She might need that in the ninth end if she gets to that stage.
And this, of course, these statistics are just for this event, over seven games.
So, in fact, they have encouraged Moiseeva to play a takeout. I'm not sure I would. I think I might play a freeze on the one in the back of the forefoot or even push the one that she's hitting to the back of the house or draw around.
It's more rocks in play. We haven't seen a lot of rocks in play in this game.
No. You know, when you're down 3 points in the sixth end, takeouts are really what you're supposed to be playing. I think, you know, softer shots, tap backs is going to get you closer to your goal.
Well, it's we got fortunate there. If it curls a little bit more, it's going right through the hole.
Yeah.
Just caught enough of it, the front one.
Stone is wide open. So Pätz can hit and stay and sit two. She'd like to roll a little bit closer toward the hit and stay and sit two. She'd like to roll a little bit closer toward the center line. Try and stay away from that corner guard as much as she can. Hit it right on the nose. Once again, Moiseeva is going to, looks like she's going to play a takeout. You want to try and maximize the number of stones. Now, so if you can push all your opponent's stones behind the T line to the 8 foot, and create a bit of a wall back there. It makes it very difficult for your opponent to get them out. But by simply playing takeouts, you're making it easy on your opponent to remove your stones.
Well, there's a very useful shot.
Nice roll, but I think you'll see Pätz just walk up and peel the corner guard off.
But with that shot, there is now set up for a
possibility for two.
Possible two.
Moiseeva is going to have to make.
Given that you don't make a mistake.
Yeah, you can't make any half shot mistakes. And even if you do, the Pätz team could set up a double by maneuvering the stones around.
A lot of end left. We're in a halfway point to this end. Still four rocks each to come.
Now she's going to choose to guard this. She could freeze the other Pätz stone in the house.
This is with this, this, my thoughts here with this curl and having, you know, it's not that easy to put those guards on a rock that's in the house.
Yep.
Mistakes are more likely to happen.
Yeah, I think she could draw in the house on the other one, just tap it back a little bit.
Might be a higher percentage shot.
And sit two, and also have something behind it to use for even later on.
Because this guard's got to be perfect, obviously.
Yep.
Not only does the line need to be right, it needs to be fairly close to the house because you can get around these guards quite easily. And we see there's the mistake right there.
I think it's half open. Guard's long and overcurled a little bit.
It's very difficult to put guards, perfect guards on.
So Pätz will try and hit this one and roll into the forefoot. Try and roll to where her brush is. Just got a corner of it.
Nadine being generous.
So Moiseeva will try and get around behind the corner guard. She knows the line of this one. They've played this area quite a few times. But the guard is far enough over that if she does get fully behind it, she may not be shot stone. Well by the guard.
Yeah. It looked like it's finishing that much in that spot.
No, maybe not as much curl.
Weight, the weight sensor.
Might have just been that much heavy.
Yeah.
Uliana Vasileva has been struggling a little bit with her draws during this game. She fired a couple through in the second end that made a couple back in the third, but hasn't been as right on the button as she would like to be.
As she has been all tournament.
Playing quietly down to this one. And the shooter spins just out of play, or out of the house. Still in play, biting the back line. Must completely cross that back line to be out of play. So one more attempt to get around behind the corner guard, and this one, if it's buried, I think you might see Pätz draw, because she would be shot stone on the her own on the other side of the house. Russia's really working this one.
Lots of room.
Okay, totally buried, but not shot stone. So you'll see Alina's tapping there. She's going to draw this time. Last time, remember, she tried to, a couple ends ago, tried to run back. I think now that it skips shots, she's going to draw T-line in the 8 foot. Hear the brushers talking about the speed of the ice. Well, the goal here is to sit two. Hopefully keep your stone in front of the tee line so the opponent can't freeze on it. Really well done. Pätz sits two.
She'll have to be shot here, right?
Well, they're
rolling
talking
over and being second shot is not going to do it for her.
If she rolls in behind the guard, she need a. Pätz would just play the same shot,
yeah.
And they'd be forced to a single. They're looking at rolling halfway or three quarters of the way over to the other one, and maybe setting up a double with the last stone.
Or Pätz making a mistake, hitting and rolling out.
I don't think they're counting on that, but I think they could. They could set up a double if they can roll over three quarters and Pätz hits it on the nose. They can set up a double takeout for her last one for a two. But this has to be a fairly precise roll. Roll over somewhere beside, on the side of the forefoot there.
Well, what I'm saying is you don't want to leave Pätz a draw. You want to at least force her to hit, right?
Yep.
Sweep! Sweep!
working it.
Even a nose hit could set up a double takeout. I think you'll see Pätz play that one. She's got to be careful. She likes just to hit it and stay right there.
It's not an easy. But I don't think the doubles are. No, they're certainly not an easy double.
If she is to hit this on the nose, it would create an angle for a double. And if she hits and rolls over toward that one, it could create a double too. So she'd like to hit it as close to the nose as she can, not roll too far. I think either way that Moiseeva will have a shot at a double here.
If she hits this on the nose, she might be hooked on that, on her own rock. So
yep.
Red one's gonna disappear
it might,
anyways.
It might spill if you make the double, yep.
But I think this needs to curl a bit more.
And this is going to set up a double.
And actually a fairly easy double, I would think.
It's almost a nose hit, just a little bit on the outside there. Spill both of them and get two.
As routine as doubles are, or are not. Straight nose hit, we'll do it. Just needs a nose hit, I think.
Yeah, a little confused with that last indication of her broom. It's kind of indicated.
She doesn't make the double. She wants to make sure she rolls in shots. Was that what it was? I don't know.
Yeah, those two spots are quite a bit different on the stone.
Yeah. So last rock here in the sixth end, and Moiseeva's got an opportunity to close up this game again a bit.
Trying to make
maybe
a curl. I think maybe taking a little too much ice. If you recall back there to the second end, they were throwing down there and it was running pretty straight and they were hitting the stones too early and rolling out. So she's given up a steal of one.
And it was maybe touch heavy also. She didn't need to throw that much weight. So Moiseeva not as sharp as she's been throughout the tournament here in the semifinal. Makes a mistake and gives up a steal. A score now of 6-2 for Pätz with a very comfortable lead going into the seventh end.
Sollen wir einen vor vier spielen? Einfach weil aufgrund dessen, dass sie so schön um die Korne gehen, dann müssen sie irgendwann angreifen.
Ja,
das
finde ich.
Zwei
spielen wir durch.
Wenn
er
gut ist, dann nehmen wir ihn raus.
Ja. Zwei ist okay.
And we're back here at the Bern Damen Cup. We're into the seventh end, and Moiseeva's left herself quite a hole to dig out of. More ends to go. Not an impossibility, but certainly need to go to work.
She certainly needs to score at least two to have any chance of winning this game. Get two, steal one is kind of her.
Yeah, stealing two is not that easy.
Well, at least you get to put up two guards. And if the other team doesn't execute the soft peels correctly, then your chances are pretty high. But Moiseeva will be pulling out all the stops this end. She'll probably play, you'll see her play two corner guards. I think you'll see Alina Pätz throw the next stone through the house. Moiseeva will put up a corner guard. Pätz will throw it through the house. Moiseeva will put up another corner guard, and then the peeling will start.
They haven't really forced the Swiss into too many tough shots, have they?
No, it's been most of it's been gifted. The points that the Swiss have got have been mostly gifted to them.
In the other semifinal, there was a force of one to Tir and Sony in the fifth end, so Tir and Sony now leads 3-2.
And they're early on in the sixth end.
And they're a little bit behind
They've had a few more stones in play, I think, over there.
I think so, too. They've had a number of stones in play. Bin Yuang with the hammer in the sixth. 2009 world champion, I believe.
Yeah, and then she took a couple of years off. And
she also won a bronze at the Olympics.
But she's back, fully committed, and
she had a
you wonder why Pätz maybe threw that stone through the house. They really don't want any stones in play that Moiseeva can use. They feel they have enough points to win this game. They don't need to score anymore, so they want to minimize the number of stones in play. So they just have one in and have thrown the other one through. Now they're going to start just peeling every stone Moiseeva puts in play. They'll just try and get rid of it and roll the shooter away. Moiseeva, of course, hoping for a few mistakes where they don't roll the shooters away and leave guards in play that she can use. Successful peel by Marissa Winkelhausen. She doesn't miss very many of those. I hope I didn't put the curse on her for the next one.
you did. So just a reminder, at approximately 2:30, I think we may be a little delayed with that start. Look what's going on up there. We'll be showing you the final of this competition. So you won't want to miss that.
One more corner guard. I don't think you'll see another corner guard after this one. They'll doesn't make much sense to throw a corner guard on your third's first one. There's only three stones to come after that one. So if this stone is successfully peeled, Moiseeva will be making a move into the house behind the other corner guard.
Tiran Soni is the defending champion 2000 from last year. So she'll, and Alina Pätz won it in 2015. And I'm looking down, of course, with a 49-year history here. I'm looking down there, and there's a very familiar winner in 1986 by the name of Linda Moore.
That was a year after they won the World Championships in 1985. They were invited to Switzerland to because they became the first Team Canada. Didn't have to qualify for the Scott Turton Arts. And so the Canadian Curling Association, in an effort to help them prepare, sent them to this tournament.
Yeah. And that was in the old facility. Not quite as nice as this one was, but it was unique and had lots of character.
Yes, it certainly did.
The crowd standing right next to the sheet.
Telling you what to do, as Linda told me. She said they were standing right beside us telling us they didn't like that call. Oh, Pätz is going to peel the guard. They're not going to go after the one in the house because going after the one in the house, a small mistake could end up costing them 3 points. And they'd be happy enough to give up a deuce here, but no more than that. That's their worst case scenario, is giving up a deuce. Whoa.
Ooh, big miss there.
That's a huge miss. You had to make some noise on that takeout.
Going down this list of winners, it's a who's who in women's curling. Very interesting historical document. You can see the program and that list of past winners going right back to 1968. If you go to the Bern website, you can link it through the Curling Champions Tour website. You can link to the Bern website, and it's got the program online. It's quite an interesting. I see all the names on there.
So that
lots of greats.
That miss by Lehman has set up the possibility for a three-ender.
Here's a return miss.
They could have got that stone around behind that corner guard. Three would definitely been in play, but as has happened this entire game, Juliana has really struggled with her draws.
Well, you can struggle with your draws as long as you come through at the right moment. Eh? But if you continue that trend throughout the game.
She's been mostly light. She's been heavy on a few and light in a few.
How much now?
Russian team are all under 27 years old, so they have a... Juliana's actually only 20, so they have a huge upside moving forward. Team Pätz are also under 20.
Yep.
Or under, pardon me, under 30.
Under 30. Lots of young teens out there, and that trend has happened in the last 10 years, too. Well, 5 years, I would think.
Yeah, they're all really athletes now. They train, they work out, they have personal training programs. Their nutrition is important. They all have nutritional information for how to eat properly for competition.
So what's this discussion about, Al?
They're talking about where to draw. So I think they've decided they're going to play hack weight on the one in the house. Just make it go away. I believe they can see. The guard's fairly long. They can see half a stone. So it's not really a difficult shot to move it from play. So they're going to play about a little bit heavier than hack weight, board weight. Lena can make this one go away. She knows the worst damage that Moiseeva can do is two. This one's sailing pretty quickly too. Got just a corner of it, enough. We weren't concerned with staying there, just
enough.
The biggest concern was just making it go away.
Well, with a four-point lead, the least amount of cherries that are laying around.
Yeah, I don't know whether that top stone is splittable. I think if I was Moiseeva, I'd make an attempt at hitting and rolling behind rather than freezing. And if you do get some kind of miss, it might be possible to split that top stone in. Maybe hitting about an eighth of the stone with hack weight. Might be able to catch it on the corner of the 12 foot and roll the shooter in. This one started to curl early. That might have picked something up. No, speeds come right
Seems
off of
way
it.
Way short, yeah.
Speeds come right off that stone. Might have been some debris under that one right from the get-go. When it's not your day, it's not your day.
No, seems that way. Played a great tournament, really solid play too. We've watched some of the games.
Yeah, they were solid in their win this morning over Sigfridsson, gave Team Sigfridsson nothing, and that game only lasted six ends.
fortunes have changed.
So that stone that Pätz has is right on the button. You can't outdraw it, so Alina's going to put a guard on it. Might be a biting guard, but there's no stones in front of the house that Moiseeva can raise. If Pätz can put a good guard on here, it'll probably ensure a victory.
Wonder if it's slowing down a little bit out there. Alan, looks like her.
Yeah, could be.
Coming up a little bit short on some of these.
Now there's a hole there, not a very big hole, as you can see between the red and yellow.
And it doesn't do much for you, does it? It's
you know, base, all you're going to do is get one or blank. Right. And being three down without or four down with, don't like your odds.
I don't like your odds either, right?
Probably three down without is a better odds. You get to put two guards up and hope for a couple of mistakes and maybe sit three on the other team.
In the sixth end here on the other semifinal, Wang took one, so that game's all tied up. Turn somebody carries the hammer into the seventh.
And they're brushing this hard. This might be the last shot of this game if it doesn't go through the hole.
Oh, nice shot.
But it does. Through.
And just sweep that out, and she did, so blank. Now, question is down four. What do you do? Would you play it, Al, or what do you think?
Well, I got to get the rocks back to the other end anyway, so.
I see, okay. And we do have the cameras on them, right? So after seven ends of play, still 6-2 for Pätz, and we're into the last end here of the semifinal. And unless there's a huge blackout on the part of Team Pätz, it should be over fairly quickly. I don't think we'll see the entire end played out. But you never know. Curling's a funny game.
Strange things have happened in this sport, but don't expect to see it in this quality of field.
At this level, probably not.
But Pätz is going to throw her two through the house. Moiseeva will only get one guard up that can't be removed.
It's for those viewers who don't know, you don't get scored for the statistics for those throw-throughs. You get they don't get calculated.
It's as if you were never they never were thrown. I've seen some people miss them, though.
How's that?
Hung it on the back of the 12 foot.
Oh, okay. Really?
They said they thought they'd throw it quiet so they could see the full curl.
Oh, yeah.
And didn't get it out.
Yeah.
In which case, they would get a zero.
Yes. Minus. Minus. Not to mention a boot and a butt from the skip, probably.
Oh, another one through the house. And it's going to be a matter of eliminating five Moiseeva stones from play, and the game will be over.
Now.
Yeah, they'll be counting the red stones in the corner.
All in all, a great event for the European champions, though.
Yep, semifinal finish.
Yeah, with this caliber field.
Yeah, we had teams like Flaxi here from Canada who didn't make it into the qualifying rounds.
Muirhead didn't qualify.
Eve Muirhead didn't make it into the qualifying play.
Lots of good teams that were left by the wayside.
Pätz could take a run at a double peel here, but she's just choosing to hit one at a time.
If it was only a two-point difference, you might try that.
Yep. She's going to eliminate the one close to the house that's possible to split in. So I think the other redstone is be impossible to split that one in, but this one does have a possibility, so she's going to take it out.
The other games, if you're wondering what the other games are, there's a consolation round for the early losers. And there's two games there, and we have a semifinal for that going on right now.
Hey, Andrea Schopp is involved in a battle with a young Swiss junior team, Jana Stritt.
Lena Nielsen against
Melanie Barbazat. Nielsen has a comfortable lead, I believe, playing the seventh end.
Now maybe try it now.
I think she's going to stick with this one because they just played it, knows the ice, made the shot. Let the player say play the same shot again.
Lisa Winkelhauser with probably her last rock in this game. And skip in. Ooh. Uh-oh. We.
That was enough.
We would. In Swiss, they call that a minimalist.
It was enough.
It was enough.
Moiseeva has a smile on her face. I think she knows that the chances of her winning this game are slim and none. But she's going to play it out anyway.
Can't fault her for that.
Not really much point in throwing up another corner guard, so she's going to get start trying to get stones in the house. She's only got five left, and has to score four of them.
Just needs to get the rest of her rocks in behind this guard, and then she can win.
Alina's not going to have that guard there. It doesn't matter which one Alina takes out of play. She just has to take one out of play every time and roll the shooter away, whether they're in the house or out of the house. So this will be the third redstone that can't score, and as soon as we get five redstones at the back of the house, the game will be mathematically over.
Nadine Lehmann. Does the job. Pätz won this event 2 years ago, in the year where she was world champion.
Probably what got them started on their roll.
Yeah. Not too many two-time winners. Gustafsson, Tirantsoni.
See that Eve Muir had won it in 2014. Just prior to their bronze medal performance at the Olympics. So it looks like this.
It's important to win this event.
This event. Jennifer Jones won it in 2010.
Put you on track for.
Put you on track for
the rest
things
of the
to come. I see Jennifer Jones has won this twice. Double. List of Gustafsson, two-time winner, late 1990s.
Rona Martin when she was in top of her game. So probably I would think the last rock here for Team Moiseeva. Certainly no reason to be ashamed. Excellent tournament for them. Proven once again that they certainly belong.
Yeah, but they'll go back with their coaches and work out the things that they could potentially do better.
I don't don't think they'll be too upset with their performance here.
Yep, they'll look at all the good stuff that happened and fix the small errors. And if they are in the World Championships, everybody look out.
Absolutely. I don't think anybody's going to underestimate them anymore anyways. That's for sure.
So four dead red stones at the back. One more will mean the game is over.
Alina Pätz looking at...
Just getting the sweepers to clean it.
Joining whoever finishes or wins that game between Tier and Sony in the end and just in the final.
Just to put an exclamation point on it, she makes the double.
Well played. Part of the Swiss. Great tournament on part of the Russian team. And at 2:30 this afternoon, close to 2:30, we maybe have a little bit of a delay getting started. The final, Al and I will be commentating that one also. We hope you look in, hope you enjoyed this game, and we'll be seeing you soon.
Later.
Later.